I remember a fight scene that happened at my school when I was still starting my studies. One boy was being threatened by a bully who wanted his lunch money. Bullying through the boy's shirt, the bully asked him to give him more money. The scene was tragic. Everyone knew the boy would not be able to beat the big guy. But the scene changed completely when a tall and strong man appeared. He was the father of the boy who came to fetch him home. He ordered the bully to release his son immediately. The bully put his head down while he heard the man say, "Never hurt my son again. He has a father. Don't mess with him." This scene showed me how a father has this protective role in relation to his children. Chapter 38 of the Book of Ezekiel brings us a war scene. On one side is the army called Gog, represented as a strong storm that destroys everything in its path. On the other side is the people of Israel, represented as a village without walls and without doors. Looking at the scene clearly sees the defeat of the people of Israel. But there's one detail that changes the whole situation. In verse 16, we read, "You will come up against my people of Israel like a cloud to cover the land. It will be in the latter days that I will bring you against my land, so that the nations may know me when I'm hallowed in you, O Gog, before their eyes." In the text, God decrees the destruction of the people of Gog and the security of the people of Israel. The reason for this unexpected turn is that Gog was going to battle against a protected people. God was the protector of Israel, so messing with them was to mess with God. So when an opponent stood against Israel, it was standing against God himself. In the same way, all those who accept to be called sons of God can, in the midst of the wars of this world, cry out for the great Heavenly Father. After all, He does not allow His children to face their enemies alone.